everyone. Today my topic is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So at the end of the session, this you student will be able to describe the morphology and antigen, pathogenesis and clinical features caused by the Mycobacterium tuberculosis, as well as choose the appropriate lab diagnosis and interpretation of the result, and prevention and treatment of the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So, first of all, we know about the general features of the mycobacteria. So, these mycobacteria are acid fastness due to the mycolic acid in the cell wall and integrity of the cell wall. So, they have a guanine plus cytosine, G plus C content of the DNA in mycobacterium. It is 61 to 71 molecular percentage into the mycobacterium tuberculosis, except mycobacterium lepra content is 54 to 57 molecular percentages, which are in a gram stain, which is weakly gram positive and obligate aerobes. And these mycobacteria, which are non-motile, non-sporing, non-capsulated, straight or slightly curved, rod shape, sometimes shows branching filamentous forms into the microscopy. These mycobacteria, they are classified into three forms. One is the Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex, which causing tuberculosis into the human. Second is the Mycobacterium lepra, other name is Hansen's bacilli, causes leprosy. And third is the non-tuberculous mycobacteria, is a anti-M, which are the saprophytes. Example is M. flea or commensals, which are the M. smegmatis, and occasionally cause opportunistic human infection by the anti-M. So first we discuss about the Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex. So in this complex, including Mycobacterium tuberculosis causing human tubercle bacilli, second is the M. bovis, bovine tubercle bacilli, third is the Mycobacterium capri, closely related to the M. bovis, M. africanum, they are isolated from a few West African cases. M. micro T is a wall bacillus, rare and less virulent. M. pinnipedi, they infect seals in the southern hemisphere and recently isolated from the human. And M. canetti is a rare isolate from East African cases that produces unusual smooth colony on solid media. So these are the example of Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex. So we discuss about the antigenic structure of the mycobacteria. They having a first is a cell wall. These are the insoluble antigen are present. First is in cell wall contain peptidoglycan layer. They maintain shape and rigidity of the cell wall. Second is the arabinogalactan layer. These are useful for the survival of the mycobacterium tuberculosis within the microphages. Third is a mycolic acid layer. This is the principal constituent of the cell wall. It's a long fatty acid chain. They confer very low permeability and it is responsible for the acid fastness and reduce the entry of the most antibiotic into the cell wall. And last is the outermost layer. It contains the lipid, glycolic and mycocytes. Proteins, they are example porins and transfer proteins. They found throughout various layers in the cell wall. Plasma membrane, which is one of the important help in attachment to host cell, and is also a target antigen used for the diagnosis. In plasma membrane, there is a limb are available, which is used for the attachment to the host cell. Lastly, the cytoplasmic, this is a soluble antigen. This include antigen 5, antigen 6 and antigen 16. They are used in serodiagnosis of the tuberculosis. Now, pathogenesis is a source of infection. There are two types. One is a human case and second is the bovine source. Human case of pulmonary tuberculosis and bovine source, which unpasteurized infected milk. Mode of transmission is, one is the inhalation mode and second is the other mode. In inhalation mode, droplet nuclei generating while coughing, sneezing or speaking. In coughing, approximately 3000 nuclei droplets can be infected. And teeny dry droplets less than 5 to 10 micrometer in size remain suspended for several hours and are easily inhaled into the respiratory systems. And other modes, which are the inoculations, may be from the skin, and another is the injections, which is a bovine type of Mycobacterium tuberculosis. risk factor they are favoring transmission as sputum positive patient. These are the microscopically positive patients with bacillary load at least 10^4 bacilli per ml causing infections. And another second is the adult cavitary lesion in lung. They are having a more bacillary load. They are a risk more efficiently transmit the infections. Third is the overcrowding in a poorly ventilated room. They poorly crowding area. There is a less ventilated room. They are more prone to infections. Low cell mediated immunity. Example is the HIV. They are most suspected. And other comorbid condition which are the post silicosis, post transplantation, hemodialysis, diabetes, IV drug abusers, smoking. These are common in other comorbid conditions. Age is a late adolescence and early adulthood, they are on risk. And in women at 25 to 34 years and men in older age are commonly risk age. How they infect us, here is a sequence of the pathogenic events, which are the one is the droplet nuclei inhaled into the respiratory system. They majority trap in upper airway and expel out. And few, they usually less than 10% reaches the alveoli. And then after they reaching the alveoli, they adhesion to the macrophage by the LAMP. It's a lipoarabinomannan presenting in the plasma membrane. Bind to the complement receptor and mannose receptor. And they furtherly internalization the bacilli. After that adhesion, they are phagocytosed by the macrophages. And they enhance by the complement C3B mediated opsonization of the bacilli. And after that phagocytosis, they survival inside the macrophages, this cell wall LAMP. They impair phagosomes, lysosome fusion by increase in intracellular calcium and phosphatidyl inositol 3-phosphate. They replicate inside the macrophages, and after replications, they rupture and release bacilli and infect the another phagocytes. First immune response, here cell-mediated immune response. In cell-mediated immune response, they are critical to contain the infections. Here, macrophages present mycobacterium antigen to T helper cells. They activate T helper 1 and T helper 2. And after that activation of the T helper 1 cells, they release interleukins 2 and interferons is a cytokines. Causing two events. One is the macrophage activating response, and second is the tissue damaging response. And balance between the this response decide outcome of the infections. Interferon activate the macrophages, and they form a tubercle as a one of the favorable sign into the lung. They are two types. One is the hard tubercle, and second is the soft tubercle. Initially, hard tubercle, which are the central zone containing activated macrophages, which are the epithelioid and giant cell, and the peripheral zone of the lymphocyte and fibroblast. And in soft tubercle, there is a difference in central part undergoes caseous necrosis and bacilli inhibited within this necrotic environment because of LOX in tension and low pH lead to the head. Second is the tissue damaging response, which are the minority of the cases associated with the risk factor. Macrophages activating response is a weak and bacilli more virulent. So over here, mycobacterium growth inhibited only by an intensified delay hypersensitivity reaction causing lung tissue restrictions. And the spread of the cases necrosis over here, one, they are spreading by direct draining into the airway causing discharge with cough. Second is the lymphatic spreadage. They are receding into the same or opposite lung as well as disseminated to the other organs. And third is the hematogenous spread to various organs. Now second is the humoral immune response. Here T helper cell 2, they release interleukins IL-4 and IL-5. They activate B cell and then they activate the antibodies. And M tuberculosis being obligate intracellular organism, so humoral immunity plays a minor role, and anti-LAM, LAM antibody play a role in preventing dissemination of the tuberculosis into the children. Now, clinical features of the mycobacterium tuberculosis, which are the one is the pulmonary tuberculosis, second is the extrapulmonary tuberculosis. The pulmonary tuberculosis is 80% of the all cases of the tuberculosis, and extrapulmonary nowadays are 15 to 20% of the all cases of the tuberculosis result from the hematogenous disseminations. So, what is the primary versus secondary tuberculosis, pulmonary tuberculosis, which are the features are result due to the in primary tuberculosis initial exogenous infection with the tuberculous bacilli, and in post or primary or secondary PTB they are the due to the exogenous reinfection and endogenous reactivation of the latent primary lesions. Their age group affected primary PTB is in children, and post secondary infection which are commonly into the adults, and part of the lung commonly infected is in primary pulmonary TB are subpleural lesion affecting upper part of the lower lobe and lower part of the upper lobe. Same in another side, post primary or secondary PTB, they are infecting apical and posterior segment of the upper lobes. They are high oxygen tension are there. Now lesion form at the initial site in primary PTB is a fibrotic nodular lesion, is a known as Gons focus. And in post primary or secondary PTB is a calcified nodules or known as a Eisenmann's focus. The early hematogenous spreading in apex of the lung is known as Simon's focus. So Eisenmann focus and Simon focus, which are the sign into the primary or secondary TB, and Gons focus, which are sign will be the into the primary PTB. Lymph node, Gons focus with associated hilar lymphadenopathy is commonly called as a primary complex, and into the post primary secondary PTB lymph node involvement is unusual into the post infections. Clinical features in a primary PTB, it may be the asymptomatic or may present with a fever, productive cough with or without hematosis, and occasionally chest pain, night sweating and weight loss can be there. In post or primary secondary PTB, lesion undergoing necrosis and tissue destruction leading to the cavity formation, symptoms are similar but more pronounced. Primary PTB lesions is spontaneously, and primary complex become calcified, known as Ranke complex. And into the post primary or secondary PTB, bronchogenic spread to the same or opposite lung form satellite lesion, causing causing pneumonia, and hematogenous spread to various part of the body and granuloma formation really they heal spontaneously. In extrapulmonary tuberculosis, tuberculous lymphadenitis is the most common form, 35% of all extrapulmonary tuberculosis. The posterior cervical and supraclavicular lymph node is a painless swelling in the neck region without a warmth or color changes. Second is a pleural tuberculosis. There are 20% causing pleural effusions. Tuberculosis of the upper airway, you know, larynx, pharynx and epiglottitis. Genitary urinary tuberculosis is the renal tuberculosis. Genital tuberculosis in a female in the fallopian tube and endometrium causing infertility, and in a male they causing a epididymis. Skeletal tuberculosis is a weight bearing joints involved, which are the spine, hip and knees, and complication are collapse of the vertebral bodies causing kyphosis and paravertebral collapses are common. And tuberculosis of the CNS commonly affected in children. Tuberculosis meningitis and tuberculoma are there. And tuberculosis pericarditis is a direct extension from the adjacent lymph node or following hematogenous spread. Gastrointestinal tuberculosis is a terminal ileum and cecum due to the swelling of the sputum with direct seeding, hematogenous spread or ingestion of cow milk contaminated with the M. bovis. Tuberculous skin lesion, which are the scrofuloderma, skin involvement by direct extension from the underlying tuberculous lymphadenitis. Lupus vulgaris is a apple jelly nodules are formed over a face, and miliary or disseminated tuberculosis, which are the hematogenous spread causing yellowish 1 to 2 mm size of granulomatous lesion resembling millet seed in a various organ. So this is a miliary tuberculosis. Epidemiology, 1/3 world population infected asymptomatically with the M tuberculosis. 5 to 10% developed clinical diseases. In 2016 WHO, 10.4 million new cases of the tuberculosis occurred, with 1.7 million deaths are there. Over 95% of TB death in low and middle income countries. Seven countries account for 64% of the total TB burden. In India, 25% total TB case and 33% of total TB death are there. Indonesia, China, Philippines, Pakistan, Nigeria and South Africa, this country accounts 64%. TB is the ninth leading cause of the death in a worldwide. Now we go for the laboratory diagnosis. So over here, specimen collections in pulmonary TB is a sputum and spot sample and early morning sample are collected if you are suspected pulmonary TB. At least 2 to 5 ml of the sputum are collected into the Falcon tube or universal containers, container, and preferably mucopurulin should be there. In extrapulmonary specimens, in optimum specimen, which are the CSF, spinal, pericardial, synovial, SIT, blood and bone marrow, pleural biopsy, tissues collected in a saline, and suboptimal specimen is the organisms load is less. The pleural fluid 20 to 50 ml is collected and centrifuge. Blood indicated only for the disseminated TB and HIV TB co-infections. Swab only recommended swabs is laryngeal swab collected early morning air, empty stomach and swab from the discharging sinuses. Urine 3 early morning specimen collected 500 ml per specimen and after that centrifuge it on different days. Stool, it is used for disseminated TB in HIV infected patient and infants. Other respiratory specimen, which are the bronchial secretions, 2.5 ml required, bronchoalveolar lavage 20 to 50 ml, and transbronchial and other biopsies. And gastric lavage recommended for children 10 to swallow sputum or ICU patient aspiration. Early morning lavage should be collected and processed early in less than 4 hours. After the collection of the sample, there is the processes which are the digestion, decontamination and concentration. So in digestion, which are the to liquefy the thick pus cells and homogenization. Second is the decontamination, which is to inhibit the normal flora into the specimen, and concentration to increase the elongated bacilli. After that, there are two methods which can be the Petrov's method and NALC. So in Petrov's method, 4% sodium hydroxide which are added in the specimen, and then they centrifuge and neutralize with the 8% HCl. And second is the NALC is N-acetyl L-cysteine plus 2% NaOH. So NALC liquefies the sputum and NaOH kill the normal flora. These are the role and superior and more compatible with automated culture system. After that, direct microscopy are useful. So all we know about the Zn strain. So acid fast staining Zn strain technique are useful for the mycobacterium tuberculosis. So interpretation is negative result greater than 100 oil immersion fields 10 to 15 minutes we should be examined under the microscope. If positive result, long slender bidded less uniformly stained red color bacilli, you can see over here into the this picture. So if we do microscopy, they provide only presumptive diagnosis. So advantages which are the rapid and easy to perform and cheaper, and disadvantages are there. The laser less sensitive than the culture, detection limit is 10,000, 10 is to 4 bacilli per ml sputum are required for the positive result. They cannot determine viability of the bacilli and difficult to differentiate from the saprophytic mycobacteria. And acid alcohols, M tuberculosis acid and alcohol fast, and M smegmat is only acid fast, but not it is the alcohol fast. Second method is the Kinyon's cold acid fast staining. Is over here heating is not required, so known as the cold acid fast staining. Over here phenol concentration in carboxylation is increased, and second is a fluorescent staining. Is a 0.1% oramine and fluorescent LED microscope are using, and brilliant yellow bacilli are seen over here. There you can see into the picture, and these are the fastest screener method, and 2 minutes for 100 fold we should examine it. So So, as per the RNTCP guideline for the grading of the sputum smear, is number of bacilli seen is the greater than 10 bacilli per all emergent field. Is grading plus 3, so number of all emergent to be screened should be 20. 1 to 10 bacilli per all emergent field is grade is a 2 plus. So number of all emergent to be screened is a 50. 10 to 99 bacilli per 100 all emergent fluid is a 1 plus. So they need 100 all emergent fluid should be screened. 1 to 9 bacilli per 100 all emergent fluid is the known as scanty, and number of all emergent fluid should screen as a 100, and no FAB in 100 all emergent fluid is a nil, and at least 100 oil immersion field should be screened, then you can diagnose it is a negative. So these are the very important for the microscopy. These are the useful for the monitoring the treatment response of the patient, assessing the severity of the disease, assessing the infectiousness of the patient, and the higher the grade, more is the infectiousness. Smear negative patients less than 10^4 bacilli per ml of the sputum are less infectious. Now second is the after microscopy culture method, which are advantages are that it is more sensitive, detection limit is a 10 to 100 viable bacilli, and they are indicating viability of the bacilli, and drug susceptibility testing can be performed by the culture method. So over here conventional solid media is a, we are using LJ media, most widely used and recommended by the RNTCP, and composition of this media are coagulated hand egg, mineral salt solution, asparagine and malachite green as a selective agent, and incubation period is a 6 to 8 weeks. After 8 weeks, we can be, if there is no growth, it is negative. So over here, if there is any growth within 8 weeks, so there is a typical rough, tough and buff colored colony will be there. So over here we can see here, and if there is a M bovis, there is a smooth, moist and white colored colony which break up easily when touched. So it is the embryos. So these are the difference between two Mycobacterium tuberculosis and bovis in a colony. Another is a nowadays we are using automated liquid culture other than solid media. So they monitor growth continuously and offer a faster turnaround time. 99% of the positive growth get detected within 3 to 4 weeks. So this is the faster method. Here is we are using Middlebrook 7H9 medium supplement with the OADC enrichment growth media and Penta antibiotic mixture. So OADC means oleic acid, albumin, dextrose and catalase. They promote the growth of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and another is a VA Penta antibiotic mixture, which are the polymyxin B, amphotericin B, nalidixic acid and trimethoprim and azelocillin. They inhibit other organisms. So these are the automated Bactec MGIT Mycobacterium growth indicator tube. These are the tube and these are the instrument. So this detect growth of the mycobacteria, and drug susceptibility testing both we can be do by the midget. So principle of this test is a autosensitive fluorescent compound in the broth quenches emission from the fluorescent compound. The quenching effect is lost if organism grow on use O2. So over here fluorescent compound are there. Okay. Then second is the Versatex system. They detect change in a pressure in head space due to the production of CO2 by the enterotoxicosis, and drug susceptibility testing against first line anti-tuberculosis drug. Back alert. They colorimetric detection of the pH change due to the CO2 liberated by the M. tuberculosis. Growth subjected to acid fast strain. Further testing if found be positive. MPT64 antigen. These are rapid tests. Detection by the rapid immunochromatic chromatographic test. They can be done after the growth detected into the media. Biochemical test. We are using niacin test, nitrate reduction and pyrazinamide test. Almost obsolete now. Rabbit pathogenicity test. M. bovis is pathogenic to rabbit. Various M. tuberculosis is not pathogenic, so it is also obsolete now. serological tests are not recommended nowadays. Both antigen and antibody detection methods are into the serological methods. Low sensitivity and cross-reactivity with other mycobacteria are there. And variable antibody response against different epitopes are there. So WHO has banned the use of the serological test. A molecular method takes less time than culture, more sensitive than culture, useful for the extrapulmonary samples, and they detect gene coding for drug resistance. So PCR we use. So over here into the PCR, nested PCR and CBNAT are used. So into the nested PCR targeting IS6110 gene, and other gene are MPT64 gene, 65 KDA and 38 KDA genes we detect into the nested PCR. And second is most important is a cartridge-based nucleic acid amplification test is a CBNAT system endorsed by the WHO and RNTCP. And nowadays we are using over here in our DTC. So result is into the CBNAT is a very rapid and we can detect in within 2 hours. And principle is these are the real-time PCR technique detect MTB complex DNA and rifampicin resistant. So mutation of the ROPB gene can be detected. There is a no contamination are there if it employs single-use disposable cartridge we are using in this test. And procedure is the entire process, sample processing, nucleic acid extraction, amplification and reporting of the result is fully automated. Once we enter load the sample, after that directly we detect the result, interpret the result. So no need to the sample processing, extraction and amplification of the sample. EPTB WHO recommend gene expert is as the initial test using CSF lymph node and other tissue specimens. And diagnostic utility detect limit 131 bacilli per ml of the specimen. Compared to the culture detection of the TB bacilli is 88% sensitive and 99% specific. And detection of the rifampicin resistant, it is the 95% sensitive and 98% specific. So disadvantages of the gene expert is very expensive and cannot further speciate. So these are the instrument gene expert. Then LPA, line probe assay, is a detect the amplified DNA in this specimen. Use of the LPA in a TB diagnostic and identification of the MTB complex, detection of the resistant to the antitubercular drugs. They include the first line and second line drug. And speciation of the MTB complex and anti-M can be detected by the LPA. So these are the very useful method. And it is also included into the our RNTC program. And their limitation is that can be performed only on positive culture or smear positive clinical specimen. So we need first culture this sample, and after if there is any growth, we take this growth and then use in line probe assay. Commercial kit is a genotype and LIPA. We are using systems used to perform this assay, twin incubator and GT blot. Principle is a 2 to 3 days of turnaround time. DNA extraction from the clinical specimen are needed. Multiplex PCR amplification with the biotinylate primers are using, and reversible hybridization is a chemical denaturation of the amplicons, and then hybridization and streptavidin, then conjugate alkaline phosphatase and detect hybrid by biotin streptavidin moieties. So line probe assay, TB bacilli, sensitivity 81.5% and specificity is 87.5%. Rifampicin resistance is 97%, they detect sensitivity, and specificity is 99%, and isoniazid resistance is 90%, and this specificity is 90%. So LPA is useful particularly in isoniazid monoresistant cases of the TB which are not diagnosed by the gene expert. Upcoming methods for the TB diagnosis are TrueNAT, is a MALBIOS, is a chip-based real-time PCR, is a TrueNAT. Automated battery-operated devices can be used at primary health care centers. Unit 1 sample preparation devices is a DNA extraction, then Unit 2 is an analyzer, is the extracted DNA is added to the chip, coated with the probes and loaded for the amplification. So disadvantage of this method is that it is very expensive, cannot further speciate MTB complex and test one sample at a time. Then another is the TB lamp method. It's a loop mediated isothermal amplification method. They are alternative to smear microscopy for the identifications by WHO. Does not detect drug resistance, only they identify the organisms. Next generation gene expert is the expert ultrasound cartridge with larger chamber of DNA amplification to the accommodate large amount of sputum required. Two additional molecular target to detect the TB, and these are the most sensitive and specific with detection limit of 60 bacilli per ml compared to the 131 bacilli per ml of first generation gene expert. So these are the very sensitive. Breach biomarkers such as the volatile organic compound LAM is a lipoarabinomannan antigen detection into the urine and sputum. Another method is a intergam rapid immunosuspension assay, is a FN from the extrapulmonary sites, IGRA, other name is automated microscopy and image detections, non-commercial culture and drug susceptibility testing, microscopic observation of the drug susceptibility and colorimetric redox indicator method. They are using a non-commercial culture and drug susceptibility testing, but not performed nowadays. RNTCP guideline is in 2016 is a presumptive pulmonary TB, so cough less than 2 weeks, fever greater than 2 weeks, and significant weight loss, hemoptysis, and any abnormalities into the chest X-ray. Nowadays, if a patient have any cough and fever, they can be included as a presumptive pulmonary tuberculosis. So, presumptive drug resistant TB cases, TB patient who have failed treatment with first line drugs. Second is a pediatric TB non-responder, TB patient who are contacted of the DRTB cases, TB patient found positive on any sputum smear examination during treatment with first line drug and previously treated TB cases, and again this patient have a TB sign, and new TB patient with the HIV co-infection. These all are included as a presumptive drug resistant TB cases. So this is the one of the diagnostic algorithm for the tuberculosis. Tuberculin test. These are the useful for the diagnosis of the latent tuberculosis by demonstration of the type of 4 hypersensitive reaction against the tubercle bacilli antigen. This is discovered by the von Prickwert in 1907. Antigen used in the tuberculosis test, OT, old tuberculin antigen. These are the crude preparation, not used now. And PPD is a purified protein. There it is. Antigen is a purified preparation of the active tubercular proteins. And PPD RT23 with the twin ET PPD recommended by the WHO. Dose is a 1 tuberculin unit is equal to 0.01 ml of the OT or 0.00002 milligram of the PPD. So procedure is the Montauk trace is injected intradermally into flexure surface of the forearm. HIF and TINI multiple puncture test are not in use nowadays. Reading is the very important. After 48 to 72 hours with of the induration, so is there greater than or equal to 10 mm our indurations are there, it is the positive, is a tuberculin reactors. 6 to 9 mm is the equivocal or doubtful reactions, and less than 5 mm is the negative reactions. So interpretation of the result are adult positive only indicate present of past exposure with the tubercle bacilli and only use as a epidemiological marker. And these are diagnostic marker into the children, is a positive test indicate active infection. There is a false positive due to the BCG vaccinations after 8 to 14 weeks and non-tuberculous mycobacterial infection, so they will be the false positive. And there is a false negative, is the earlier advanced TB, miliary TB, decreased immunity in HIV infected people, and 2-step testing in adult is a rapid test 1 to 2 weeks after the first test is a booster effect, strong positive reaction greater than 20 mm. Another is a latent diagnosis of the latent tuberculosis, the IGRA is a interferon gamma release assay. Highly specific M tuberculosis antigen is CFV10 and ESAT6. Procedure is in vitro test, patient sensitized T lymphocyte exposed to the ESAT6 and or CFV10 antigen. Then release of the high level of the interference from the T lymphocyte. So this will be detected. QuantiFERON TB gold assay is a commercially available ELISA format test. And advantages is the highly specific, no false positive result are there. Then treatment is a first line included isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, ethambutol and streptomycin. And second line drugs we are using ethanamide and prothionamide, quinolones, aminoglycoside, cyclosarin and apera, salicylic acid, macrolides and beta-quiline, which are approved in 2015. So, agent with the unclear efficiency, which are the clofazimine, linezumide, amoxicillin, clavulinic acid, thioacetazone, meropenem, clavulinic acid, imipenem, or cilastatin and clarithromycin are there. Treatment of the tuberculosis, which aim is to interrupt transmission by the rendering patient, the non-infectious, prevent morbidity and death by the patient, prevent the emergence of the drug resistance and relapse. Then multi-drug therapy, there are short-course chemotherapy and two-phase chemotherapy. Short-course chemotherapy is for the 6 months and two-phase therapy is one is the intensive phase and second is the continuation phase. In intensive phase, 2 to 3 months and continuation phase is at 4 to 5 months. These are intensive phase aggressive treatment that rapidly kill bacilli making the patient smear negative and continuation phase is killing remaining dormant bacilli and prevent the relapse. So, DOTS is a direct observation treatment, it's a short course. Another is very important is the primary or pre-treatment drug resistance, the infection of the individual by a drug resistant strain that not previously been treated and these are the less common. And acquired resistance, these are the secondary or post-treatment, initially sensitive, become resistant later due to inappropriate or inadequate treatment and these are the most common nowadays. Another terminology is a mono-resistant, which means resistant to only first-line AKT. Polyresistance means resistant to greater than one first-line AKT, except isoniazid and rifampicin together. So it should be only one. Then rifampicin-resistant, RR, is a rifampicin-resistant with or without resistant to other AKT excluding isoniazid. And multi-drug resistant tuberculosis MDR, which is resistant to isoniazid and rifampicin with or without resistant to the other first line. So into the MDR, TB, isoniazid and rifampicin should be there. Now XTR, which are the definition is the MDR, TB cases also resistant to the fluoroquinolone. So isoniazid, rifampicin plus fluoroquinolones, ofloxa or levofloxacin, and at least one injectable aminoglycoside. So this should be there. It is known as XDR. So at least one injectable aminoglycoside. Say which are the example is the kanamycin, amikacin, and capreomycin should be there. So epidemiologically, 6.2% of the TB cases are XDR nowadays. So India exact incidence is unknown, and TB treatment failure cases 2 to 6% may be presumed to be XD TB cases, and treatment of the XD TB is extremely difficult. So, beta-quiline are inserted into the 2015 miracle drug for the XDR TB, inhibit mycobacterium ATP synthase and strongly mycobactericidal. There is no cross resistance with other AKT. And indications are MDR TB or XDR TB cases which are resistant to fluoroquinolones and or second line injectable drugs. And regimen is beta-quiline containing regimen should contain 4 other second line AKT depending up on the sensitivity. Global and national TB programs are RNTCP, the NTB strategy, the national strategic plan India is 2017 to 2015. Nixia is a web-based solution for the monitoring of the TB patient directly. There is the software, and all new cases should be reported into this web portal, as well as they follow the all the treatment of the patients. BCG, we know about it. Thank you.